I have come up to make you a star performer in solving this most important problem. If you follow these videos, you will see improvement gradually. It will not happen instantly, but eventually it will happen and you will start noticing your progress. And let's get started to solve the problem on Fourier series. Obtain the Fourier series expansion of f of x given that f of x is equal to pi minus x whole square in 0 less than x less than 2 pi and deduce the value of this. According to the Fourier series, we have the formula that f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity b n sin nx. So we have to find the value of a naught, a n and b n and substitute in this. For finding a naught, so what is the formula here? For finding a naught, it is 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into dx. So for finding the value of a n, see for value of a n, it is 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into cos nx into dx. And for finding the bn value, the formula here is 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into sin nx into dx. So after getting all these values, we have to substitute in the main formula. So here f of x is given as, so from the question f of x is given as x minus pi minus x whole square. So we first of all, I am going to calculate a naught value. A naught is equal to 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into dx. So a naught is equal to 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi, this is pi minus x whole square of dx. As you know that integral x square is nothing but x cube by 3. So this will be pi minus x whole cube by 3, and for minus x it is, it will be minus 1 between the limits 0 to 2 pi. Now I am going to substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. First of all, what is the upper limit here? Pi minus 2 pi whole cube by minus 3, minus of minus plus, that is pi minus 0 whole cube by 3. So now a naught value is equal to 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus 2 pi, it will be minus pi. Minus pi whole cube, it is nothing but minus pi cube by minus 3, and this is also pi cube by 3. If I cancel this one, then a naught value will be 1 by pi times of 2 pi cube by 3. If I cancel this for one time, then a naught value is 2 pi square by 3. So you have to observe that we got the value of a naught as 2 pi square. This is 2 pi square by 3. And next we have to go for the value of a n. For finding the value of a n, we have the formula ready here as, for a n value, what is the formula here? 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into cos nx into dx. So what is f of x here? F of x is nothing but from the question it is pi minus x whole square. If I substitute and calculate the value of a n, then a n value will be, a n is equal to 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x, in place of f of x I am writing as pi minus x whole square into cos nx into dx. So this is of u and v rule. So integral u v dx is nothing but u we have to leave, v we have to integrate, minus d by dx of u integral v dx whole dx. In this formula, if I substitute, then a n value will be 1 by pi times of, see u I have to leave as it is, that is pi minus x whole square. After that v I have to integrate, this is v. For integral cos x is nothing but sin nx by n, minus integral derivative of u, what is the derivative of u? That is 2 times of pi minus x, and again for minus x it is minus 1, and again I have to integrate v. So what is the integration of cos nx? It is nothing but sin nx by n of dx. So this will be, a n value will be 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus x whole square sin nx by n, minus into minus, this is plus 2 by n, if I take outside, then this will be pi minus x into sin nx into dx. So again, this is of the form of UV rule. So for UV rule, U have to leave, V we have to integrate, minus d by dx of U, integral V dx whole dx. If I substitute in this formula, then an value will be, so an value will be 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus x whole square sin nx by n plus 2 by n times of, this is U I have to leave as it is, this is pi minus x, V I have to integrate, that is minus cos nx by n minus derivative of this one. So the derivative is minus 1, and for sin x it is minus cos nx by n of dx. So an value will be, so an value will be 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus x sin nx by n. And if you observe, this is plus and this is minus. This will be 2 by n square times of, this is pi minus x into cos nx, and minus into minus, this is plus and this is also plus. This will be minus into minus, this is plus and this is minus. This is 2 by n square times of cos nx into dx. So this one, an value will be 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus x times of sin nx by n minus 2 by n square of pi minus x into cos nx, and integral sin nx is nothing but, cos nx is nothing but sin nx by n. Here it is already n square. So this will be n cube. So between the limits 0 to 2 pi. So I have to substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. So an value will be 1 by pi times of, this is pi minus 2 pi sin, in place of x I have to write 2 pi. So that is 2 pi n by n minus 2 by n square. In place of x I have to substitute 2 pi cos 2 pi n minus 2 times of sin 2 pi n by n cube minus the lower limit. I have to substitute 0 here in place of x. So this will be pi minus 0 sin 0 by n minus into minus, this is plus 2 by n square. 2 by n square, this will be pi minus 0 by cos 0. So this is minus of minus plus 2 by sin 0 by n cube. So you have to note a certain things, that is sin 2 pi n is always 0, cos 2 pi n is 1, and cos 0 value is 1, and sin 0 value is 0. So you have to substitute all these values. Sin 2 pi n value, it is 0 here, and sin 0 value is also 0, sin 2 pi n value is also 0, and sin 2 n 0, and only these two remain. So an value will be, so this will be minus 2 by n square, and this is minus pi into 1, and here if you see, this is 2 pi n square, pi times of cos 0 is 1. So an value will be 2 pi by n square, and this is also 2 pi by n square. So this will be 4 pi by n square. So I forgot this 1 by pi to write outside. So there is 1 by pi. So here it is 1 by pi, and therefore if you observe that an value is equal to 4 by n square. So I got the value of an also, and later I have to find the value of bn. As you all know that bn formula, the formula for bn is nothing but, so bn is nothing but 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x into sin nx into dx. Then what is f of x here? F of x from the question is nothing but pi minus x whole square. Now I am going to substitute this one. So bn value, so if you see, bn is equal to 1 by pi times of integral 0 to 2 pi f of x is nothing but pi minus x whole square, this is the sin nx of dx, and this value is u and this value is v. So integral uv dv is nothing but, integral uv dx is nothing but u you have to leave, v we have to integrate, and d by dx of u and v dx whole dx. In this formula, if I substitute, then bn value will be, see, our bn value will be 1 by pi times of u I have to leave as it is, that is pi minus x whole square, v I have to integrate, this is minus cos nx by n minus derivative of u. You have to make a derivative, that is 2 times of pi minus x, and for x it is minus 1, and again v I have to integrate, that is minus cos nx by n of dx. See our bn value here, it is, so bn is 1 by pi times of, this is minus pi minus x whole square cos nx by n, here minus of minus, this is plus and this is again minus, that is 2 by n times of, this is pi minus x into cos nx into dx. If you observe carefully, again this is of UV rule, u you have to leave, v we have to integrate, minus d by dx of u, integral v dx whole dx. If I substitute in this formula, then bn value will be 1 by pi times of minus, this is pi minus x whole square cos nx by n. So this is minus 2 by n times of u I have to leave as it is, that is pi minus x. V I have to integrate, this will be sin nx by n minus derivative of u. The derivative of u is nothing but minus 1, and integration of v, it is sin nx by n of dx. So bn value, so bn value will be 1 times of, this is minus pi minus x whole square cos nx by n. If I multiply this one, this will be 2 by n square, this is pi minus x sin nx, and this is minus into minus plus, and this is minus, that is 2 by n square integral sin nx into dx. So this is, this can be written as bn is equal to 1 by pi times of minus, this is pi minus x cos nx by n minus 2 by n square pi minus x sin nx, and this is for integral sin nx, it is nothing but minus cos nx by n. So this will be 2 by n cube cos nx between the limits 0 to 2 pi. So now I am going to substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. So bn value, if you see, 1 by pi times of minus of pi minus 2 pi cos, in place of x I have to write 2 pi. So 2 pi n by n minus 2 by n square, this is pi minus 2 pi sin 2 pi n plus 2 by n cube cos 2 pi n, and here for lower limit it is minus of minus, this is plus pi minus, in place of x I have to substitute 0, this is cos 0 by n, minus of minus, this is plus 2 by n square, this is pi minus 0, this is sin 0, and minus 2 by n cube, this will be cos 0. You have to remember certain values, that cos 2 pi n value is always 1, and sin 2 pi n value is always 0, and sin 0 is always 0, and cos 0 value is 1. So here this will be 0, this will be 0, and what remains, these all values, 4 values remains. Therefore bn value is equal to 1 by pi times of, so here if you observe this one, there is a square here, and if you see, there is square here, pi minus x whole square. So if you observe this one, pi minus 2 pi, minus pi whole square, it is nothing but plus pi, this will be minus pi by n, and cos 2 pi n value is 1, and if you go here, this will be 2 by n cube times of cos 2 pi n value, I have said it is 1. If you see here, this is plus pi square by n, and cos 0 value is 1, and if you see here, this is n cube into 1. So bn value will be 1 by pi times of minus pi by n 2 pi n cube plus pi square by n minus 2 pi n cube. So this is plus 2 by n cube minus 2 by n cube, and the bn value, the final value, we got bn as 0. So all the values are ready here, and we got the final formula as f of x is equal to, so as you can see here, f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity बी एन साइन एन एक्स. सो वी गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए नॉट एज. सो जस्ट नाउ आई हैव कैलकुलेटेड हियर. आवर ए नॉट वैल्यू इज रेडी एज see here, this is b naught, this is a n, and this is a naught. A naught is 2 pi square by 3 here, that is 2 pi square by 3, and we got the value of a n as 4 by n square, and b n value is 0. So see here, the b n value is 0. If I substitute and f of x, the final value is nothing but pi minus x whole square. So we got the value ready as pi minus x whole square is equal to what is a naught. This is 2 pi square by 3 into 2 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. What is a n? That is 4 by n square cos nx plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity. What is the b n value? 0 into sin nx. So this will be pi minus x whole square. If I cancel this one, so this will be pi square by 3 times of 4. If I take outside, this will be sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity cos nx by n square. If I take 4 common from this, so this will be, if I take 4 common, then this will be pi square by 12 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity cos nx by n square. So if I keep x is equal to 0, so put x is equal to 0 and see what will happen here. If you see, put x is equal to 0, then you can see that pi minus x, pi minus 0 whole square is equal to 4 times of pi square by 12 plus sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity cos 0 into anything cos 0. So if I keep x is equal to 0 here, then this will be, what, put x is equal to 1 here, put x is equal to 0, this will be 0 by n square. So then pi square is equal to 4 times of pi square by 12. If I keep n is equal to 0 here, n is equal to 1, that will be 1 by 1 square. So 1 by 1 square, so this will be 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 4 square plus and so on. So then if I send 4 to this side, this will be pi square by 4 is equal to pi square by 12 times of 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square and plus on so on. Therefore here, if you see this bracket, 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square and so on value will be pi square by 4 minus pi square by 12. If I take 12 as LCM, then this will be 3 pi square minus pi square, which is equal to 2 pi square by 12, which is equal to pi square by 6. Therefore 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 3 square and plus on so on is equal to pi square by 6. So this is how we have to deduce from the formula by putting x is equal to 0. So hopefully these videos will be very helpful to you, and the ultimate purpose of solving and explaining is to make your job easier. If you really like this video, the only thing you have to do is share it with your friends. Please pass it on and subscribe to my channel and have a look at my next video too.